ASP.NET Core defines a lot of interesting types and properties that we could use to inspect the incoming requests. We can even define the types of information we want to pull out of the requests and have provided to our action methods as parameters. And this process is usually referred to as binding. Now, when it comes to binding, there's a lot of different parts from that request that we can get information from. So for instance, we might want to get information from the body or from an HTTP header or even the query string. And we usually refer to these as binding sources. And the way that we specify a binding source inside of our code is, well, we can use binding attributes. So we can use a from attribute and say, I want to get information from the header or from the body, or I want to get it from the query string. Now, let's take a look at a practical example and see how we can use these binding parameters inside of Visual Studio. Let's take another look at our get operation inside of our recipes controller. Now, a common ask whenever requesting resources is to be able to limit the number of resources to get returned from our API. And one way we could do this is by specifying a count parameter. Now, where exactly is this information is going to come from? Well, like we mentioned before, we can use those binding attributes. And so here I'm specifying from query. So that means that ASP.NET Core is going to pull that from the query string. The next thing that I want to do is use that parameter inside of my action method. So here you can see I'm using the take method from link to return the right number of recipes. Let's go ahead and run this and see what happens. Now that my Swagger UI is up, let's inspect that get operation. Notice that I have that count parameter available for me to use. And I could give it a value and let's execute it. 1, so that's the right number. And then 2, there you go. So we know that the right value is being pulled out of the query string and supplied to our action method. Now, this is not the end of binding, and there's way more sources that we could use to supply information to our web API. But we're going to take a look at some of those a little further on in the series.